Retired military, retired detail attorney, and 10 military modern check, in the county, missile going across from Iowa. Continue to leave the county as unnecessary, destined to be a threat to the United States, that the army concerned. As also much we don't know about the oil permits and new weapons capability. In addition, many other Asian nations are investing significantly in modernization. Tensions continue to flare across the south and east China Sea. Indonesia and Philippines continue to struggle against terror. And throughout much of the Southeast Asia, the threat of violence and instability remains extraordinarily high. Pandemics and natural disasters have also taken a heavy toll on the region. It's clear that the United States must work to strengthen and focus on the Asia Pacific region in the near future. Well, ladies and gentlemen, let me conclude by urging those of you who are students to take advantage of the opportunity afforded you at the University of Harvard. Take advantage of it and take time to really wrestle with the dignity of this era and history. You'll find when you leave the halls of academia that the pressing concerns of daily life make devoting significant time to issues that bring strategy almost impossible to recover. So give these weighty matters as much thought as you can. Do it now. And there are now many critical strategic thinking that will inform and assist your decision making for the rest of your life. I'm just telling you a story. I never decided just what I said. 1935. Young Fred Schwingle from Iowa came down to Missouri and attended the Northeast Missouri State Teachers College at Kirksville, Missouri. The newly elected United States Senator from Missouri. The man was visiting in the early 1935 the various colleges, and he went to Kirksville, and the president of the Northeastern University Teachers College introduced young Fred Schwingle to the new senator. Young Fred was president of the student body. Young Fred was on the dean's honor list, and on and on he went. The senator ignored all that and looked at young Fred, and he said, "Young man, if you want to be a good American, you must know your history." Fred Schwingle told me that story when he was of his age. His wife was a tenured member of Congress from Iowa and later became the historian of the United States Capitol. Wonderful man. And related that because of the man that I had met when I was a teenager. It came to his inauguration and his president. None of them deserves Harry S. Truman. Harry Truman was a historian that helped him make decisions. Not too long after he passed away, Margaret, his daughter, took me by their home in attendance with her and introduced me to Mrs. Truman, the widow of the late President Truman. I went into his own study, and you should have seen the history books that were on the shelf. That's what he did. He understood history, and then he applied the instinct from history when he was president of the United States. You don't know what the future holds for you, but now as a student, learn the lesson that Senator Harry Truman gave to young Fred Schwingle. Because the more you understand about America, why we are what we are, our role in the world, why we have become a major special nation, you'll not only be a better man of history, you'll be able to assume a role of leadership for our country with love, but back in the moment. So Phil, he was doing it, and I must confess, I've never given a speech before with a letter around my neck. This is a real thing.
before we get to them, I just wanted a chance to introduce, I know we've had some senators coming, Senator Judy Guthard. Senator Tom Maga. Senator Frank Huddle. Before we get to them, I want to introduce Congresswoman Berdaglia for a brief announcement.
Thank you very much, Dr. Underwood, Mr. Chairman, and to all the distinguished audience tonight, and the senators and other leaders of Council General. I have a special announcement to make, and I'm sure some of the students would be interested in this. We decided to initiate an internship in our office in Washington, D.C. for one University of Guam student to intern in my district office here with an opportunity to also work in the Washington office for 2 weeks. And is that all the sentences that you said? Yes. You put a trip to Washington. So we will work on the details with President Underwood. Thank you. That's a very exciting opportunity. Now let's go to a couple of questions. I have two here. And the first one is, please comment on the plan to increase health care premiums. This will impact adversely on veterans and retirees. Please help to support Bill H-16. We are already on fixed income.
Next question. One of the goals that we have in our Congress, as well as in the White House, is to have insurance available for all Americans. Under the present time, because of the economy that we have, it's very difficult for people to pay additional premiums. I think you will see this issue addressed in this Congress, probably toward the last part of this year. We know full well the importance of health care. The health of the nation is so very, very important. And we'll do our best to glue together a proposal, a plan that will work for all people. Hopefully those premiums will not increase as the question we ask.
Thank you. Here's the next question. Will the U.S. be funding the war plans of the Tomorrow People?
I think that the gentleman from Guam can answer that. Am I right? She's been very active on that. I've been with someone else.
Mr. Chairman, you've always funded
the bill. Yes. Yes. Craig has gone wrong. My recollection is it passed in the House and it sat in the Senate.